Hi, you're watching Preem TV. I'm Eben Weiss. You may know me as Bike Snob NYC. We are here today to talk about how to do bikes in New York City with Terry Berenson, the filmmaker and cyclist behind the Hotline video. Today, we're going to show you how to shred New York City on a fixed gear bicycle, politely. How do you know you have a fixed gear bike? Well, you do a brief inspection. First, check the frame. You may have irreverent stickers on your bicycle frame. If you do, that's a good sign that you're riding a fixed gear bicycle. Another good sign is your handlebars. They're a little bit too low. You're in an uncomfortable position. Also a tip off that you're riding a fixed gear. But to really know for sure, you have to get in close and you have to perform a mechanical inspection. Now, move the pedals forward, wheel goes. Move it backwards, the wheel goes. So what you want to have first and foremost on your fixed gear bicycle is you want to have a component called a brake. Now, a brake is an amazing piece of machinery. Here's how it works. You have a lever on your handlebar. You actuate this brake, which in turn applies a retarding force to your wheel, thereby slowing the bicycle down. So you might as well get a brake. Get two brakes while you're at it. Can't go wrong. You just explained brakes to me. You showed me how crazy and loud it is in New York. What is this gonna do for me when an Uber driver is bearing down on me? Are they gonna hear it and stop? The answer is no. It's not gonna do anything for you in that scenario. But it is something that pedestrians can hear. The bell sort of affects a positive change upon all those who hear it. This is why monks meditate to bells and don't shout on your left at each other. We have our fixed gear bike, we have our brakes, we have our bell, we have our good attitude. So let's shred politely. See, Terry thought he was riding with one of his Hotline hotshots. And while I could ride that way if I chose, I choose not to because what's your hurry? The slow life is the good life. Now, I'm not gonna insult your intelligence and lie to you and tell you that I stop at every single stoplight every single time, because it's not true. However, a lot of people look at stoplights as inconveniences of urban cycling. The truth is they're opportunities, and you can't go wrong stopping at a stoplight. Not just because of safety, but the stoplight is always an opportunity to check out the landscape, soak in a little sun, take in the world around you. It's okay to look at your phone. It's one of the few times when you're on your bike, fine, take out your phone, check your messages. Contrary to popular belief, it's perfectly fine to put your foot down when you're riding a fixed gear in the city. You don't have to track stand. You don't have to stand stock still, balancing on your bicycle, sending the message to everyone around you that you're coiled and about to pounce. Doing that on a bicycle, it's like crossing the street being a sprinter ready to run the quarter mile. Instead of the track stand, try the top tube sit. It's much more dignified, much more relaxed. I got a foot down, everything's good. I hang out, I rest, I regroup, and then when the light changes, I'm ready to go. Finally, shredding New York City on your fixed gear politely. The most important thing, more than perhaps anything, is to be mindful of pedestrians. Now, this is a busy city of 8 million people. Many of them are on foot. You have to be mindful of them. Sometimes they do the things they're not supposed to do. They may step out into the bike lane without looking. They may cross against the light. It's not your job to yell at them. Your bike has brakes, remember? Feather them. You're riding slowly. It's no big deal to slow down and let them go. Accommodate them. It makes things better for all of us.